What does it mean to weld tightly our bonds of brotherhood and live as a fraternity of selfless service? Searching for meaning, we need not look further than our first shared experience, the ordeal. It was then that Brother Mateu shared with us the legend of the Lene Lenape. The legend teaches us that in order to serve our fellow men as brothers, we must have courage, honor, and a willingness to act. Are you brothers willing to act?
The volunteer spirit is something precious. I mean the spirit of the man in our legend who said, "Here am I, send me." I mean the spirit of the person who will look around and see things to be done and then go and do them in the lodge and in the camp and in life. I mean the spirit, my brothers, of the person who, undertaking the job, volunteering his service for it, will see it through, come what may.
Cynics are popular. We are charged, brothers, to be cheerful, not only in our duties, but in our thoughts as well. Irksome tasks and weighty responsibilities will challenge your resolve. Do not falter. We are called to seek the fire at the center, the very place others choose to avoid. Yet the most difficult service, carried out with a cheerful spirit, will produce the greatest benefits. We have tested our cheerfulness before, during our ordeal, and have found that a cheerful heart is as lively as a bow would under hardship.
Service. In a day when millions are interested in getting or grasping rather than giving, I am here to challenge you to serve your fellow man and brother. Winga Lausik asks you to do it cheerfully. In a day when it takes crisis to unite our nations to serve one another, I ask you to serve cheerfully without being prompted, without being provoked. Remember the words of our legend. For said he who serves his fellows is of all his fellows greatest. There are men and boys here among you that need your help, though they might not ask it of you. The ones who chose you need you. Will you extend your hand? As Brother Remoctandine charged before, are you, brothers, willing to act?
Now the order of the arrow, as we all know, is a thing of the spirit. And no thing of the spirit is such at all if it isn't of the great spirit. The order of the arrow is a thing of the outer doors, but no one can truly understand the outer doors without worshiping nature's God, Tevin. Reverence, my brothers, that thing we talk about in the 12th Scout Law, is more than a static thing, a state of mind. It's an active thing, reverence for God, or reverence for your fellow man.
Brothers, we are the chosen few that Goodman envisioned. How those coming years will be written in history relies in part on the piece you play. Will you preserve the traditions and principles of our brotherhood? Will you serve your fellows cheerfully? Will you, brothers, act? What piece will you play in our order's history?
If you, in earnest, answer these questions in the affirmative, I ask that you now rise and rededicate yourselves to the Order of the Arrow, using the words of the Song of Our Order.
Circle our council fire, well tightly the every link.